Assalamu alaikum viewers, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Links of PDF files used in this video are given in description. So today's lecture is about TGA instrumentation, and in this particular lecture we will discuss about Chevenard thermobalance. And the whole lecture series belong to the main topic of thermal methods of analysis. So as we have discussed in the previous lecture about thermogravimetric analysis or TGA, and as a result of which we obtain a thermogram. So in today's lecture we will discuss about the instrument which take that TGA analysis, and that instrument is called as thermobalance. So the qualities of a good thermobalance are summarized here. So a thermobalance should be of adequate accuracy, reproducibility and sensitivity. Accuracy means how much closer is your value towards the actual value. Reproducibility means that if we repeat a certain experiment, then it should give the same answer again and again. And sensitivity means that how much sensitive your instrument is, or how much a change in the environment is detected by your instrument. Second is, it should be operable through a wide range of temperature. As we have seen in the thermogram, that we start from the low temperature towards the high temperature. So a good thermobalance will have a greater range of temperature, like from 0 to 1000 or 0 to 5000, etc. The furnace of a balance could be heated at a linear and adjustable heating rate. So as we start from low temperature to high temperature, so the setting of the furnace or the heating area in which the sample is heated should be heated at a linear rate and with small increments, and we should have adjustable settings of that heating rate. Next is, there must be some furnace cooling arrangement so that it should be ready for the next sample. So for example, we have started from one sample and we have started temperature from 0 to 100 centigrade or 0 to 500 centigrade. So when we will take the second reading, then again the temperature should start from zero. However, if the temperature of the furnace is already 500, so we have to wait. In order to reduce that wait, we can cool the furnace. So if the cooling arrangement is there, then the furnace can be ready for the next reading very soon. Next point is, the instrument should be such that the sample container should not show any residual effects. Residual effects means you have taken one reading, and whenever you want to take second reading, then the effects of first reading should not disturb the effects of second reading. Or in other words, we will say that the two readings should be independent of each other, and there should be no relation. So this is possible only when we have a very clean sample container and it don't have any residues of the previous reading. Next is, the balance should respond rapidly to the change in sample weight. As we have discussed previously, this also takes into the category of sensitivity of the instrument, that both the heating should be increased linearly with small incremental changes, and with respect to which the balance should also show the relative changes in weight very smoothly and rapidly. Next point is, it should have high degree of electronic and mechanical stability. For example, if there is some voltage changes or if there is some weight changes, then the instrument should be of high electric and mechanical strength. Next point is, the balance should not be affected by minor sources of disturbance such as air currents. Yes, if the instrument is of good quality, then the air currents and the vibrations of these factors will not disturb our readings. However, if the quality of the instrument is not so much good, then these elements can disturb our reading. Next point is, furnace, sample container and thermocouple of the balance should be of some durable material. Yes, once again, as we are heating, and we are heating at very high temperatures, so both the sample container and thermocouple should retain their characteristics, and they should not melt or they should not contaminate our sample, and they should have a good resistance towards the high temperatures. So therefore, a good sample holder and a good responding thermocouple will give a better reading to our instrument and value. The thermocouple, why we are using thermocouple? The thermocouple will be used to measure the exact temperature of the sample. The balance should be easy and simple in operation. In general, the technique should be not so much complex, and it should not be involved so many steps, and that everyone should operate the instrument in an easy way. So this is also the good quality of a good thermobalance. There should be a provision of heating the sample under reduced pressure and inert atmosphere. Yes, if we close the sample container in a closed chamber, and then if we can reduce the pressure and create inert environment, that then this will definitely help to achieve some good results. The reason is that the heat we will provide will only affect the sample. It will not affect the air, or the presence of air can disturb our sample nature. So in order to have good results, the sample should be taken in analysis in an inert environment. So a good thermobalance should have provision of inert atmosphere. The last point is that the balance should have a capacity to hold large samples. If there is some facility that large quantity of samples should be taken into account, and also if we can attach some sample holding device with our instrument, then that will be a good quality of a particular instrument. So being a new method, a new device was produced and structured by Chevenard in 1944, and this was the very first thermobalance, which was called as Chevenard Thermobalance. And later the analysis of inorganic compounds was done by Duval and co-workers in 1953. So as this instrument or this thermobalance was a first attempt, so it not was having any good qualities of a good operators, as we have discussed in upper section. So although it was a delicate thermobalance, but in the beginning this was all that was achieved at that time. So here in this diagram we will discuss the basic components of Chevenard thermobalance. So first, it contains the light source. That light is some bulb or torch, and this light falls on a mirror. Now after refracting from mirror, this light falls on the scale. Now this mirror is fixed on a balance, and this is balance has two parts. This is the counterweight and this is the adjustable weight, and both these weights should be of having equal quantity, so that the balance should be at a balance point of a wedge. So the left side of contain the counterweight, whereas the right side contain the adjustable weight, and to this end there is attached a furnace, and this furnace consists of, these are its heating walls, and this furnace consists of sample container, and in this place the sample is placed, whereas this blue thing is called thermocouple. So this was the whole arrangement of a Chevenard thermobalance, and this whole assembly was placed on some static table. So it was open, and it was very delicate, as there was not a single closed container. So air currents, the vibrations of earth, everything was affecting. However, the achievement of this instrument is that it was a very basic instrument, and it was the start of the thermal methods of analysis. So at that time this thing was doing its purpose. And here we see this scale, and in this scale the weight starts from here. There is the 100% weight, and there is the 0% weight, and from up to down the weight decreases. So this was the basic arrangement of a Chevenard thermobalance. Now let's consider the operation or working principle of this Chevenard balance. along with discussing the thermogram, which we have discussed independently in the previous lecture. So at a balance point, we fill this with the sample container, and then we make this adjustment of the weight such that it should be at a balance point at the start of the reading. And at the start, the light came from here and it falls on this place at a balance point, which shows that at the start of the temperature and the start of the instrument, the weight is 100%. And here we see in this place, we are drawing a corresponding graph between the weight and the temperature. So here the weight is 100% of the initial amount. So as we start to increase the temperature of the furnace by heating the furnace walls, so the things mostly get vaporized, evaporated, or some gases are removed. So as a result of which, what happens that the weight of this sample containing sample is reduced. As it was initially on a balance point, as the weight of the sample decreases, so this whole thing moves upwards, and this balance shift to initially it was present at this place, and when the weight was decreased, it was shifted to this place. When it was shifted to this place, the mirror moves towards the left side, and when mirror moves, then correspondingly the light bulb reflection also moves, and it decreases from 100 to 50 or onwards, or what is the reading on the scale. So at the start there was a constant, there was the temperature was increasing, but there was no decrease in weight. But suddenly when the weight decreases with increase in temperature, so here correspondingly a curve is obtained. So again, after some time the weight become constant, and after then the weight further decreases, and in this way we gain some thermogram. So here, this was the basic principle of Chevenard balance. So as the weight decreases at this place, so the whole balance shifts, moves, and as this comes in new place, so now this mirror is shifted to this place, so it reflects the sunlight or the light from the bulb or light from the torch at a different place as compared to the initial place in the scale. So in this way, here manually we are recording the temperature, and here manually we were recording the weight, and at the end when the experiment was completed, then we draw the graph, and this was the shape of the graph, which we call it as a thermogram. So this was the basic instrument. However, it was having many disadvantages. The very first disadvantage was that it was placed on some table or some solid surface, so it was prone to any incidents, or it was prone to the vibrations of the earth. So it was also facing the current from the air current, as a result of which it was moving. So here the signal was not static, but it was fluctuating. So this was a very delicate instrument. Second thing was, there was no closed container, and if there was some closed container and we can provide the inert environment, then it was a good approach. But at that time nobody thought about that variation. So initially there was no such thing of inert environment or closed container. Next, when we were heating the furnace from 0 to 1000 or onwards, so if we want to take a second reading, then there was no cooling function in the furnace, so we have to wait for the second reading, and we have to wait until the temperature again reaches to zero or some lower range. So there was a lot of interval before we take a second reading. So this was also not a favorable as far as the experimentation is concerned. So due to these reasons, we then shifted towards the more sophisticated instrument, and that instrument is called as Aminco balance. However, Chevenard thermobalance were not so much effective, but at least we have started some instrumentation, and we got some starting point, and then further, just like spectroscopy, things were added little bit, and step by step then we got a good thermobalance, and now currently we are using a very good instrumentation, very sophisticated instrumentation and very sensitive instrumentation that is having all the qualities of a good thermobalance, which we have already discussed in the upper section. So the next thermobalance is Aminco balance, which we will learn about it in the next, and this is all about for Chevenard thermobalance. I hope you have understood the lecture well, and if you have any confusion, let me know in the comment section. I will respond immediately as soon as possible. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz.